Google's iron-tight grip on Android is the main reason a lot of Android users switch to custom firmware. But in case you don't want to do that, and the prospect of letting Google spy on your messages is not exactly an exciting proposition for you, here are the best messaging app for Android options for you. The safest option you can go with is Signal. I bet you've heard of this app before, and for a good reason. It's a gold standard for secure messaging, and even the Google Messages app switched to Signal protocol. But why use the Signal app, then? Well, good thing you asked. First of all, transparency. After all, Signal is completely open source, which honestly just means that you're not using a cat in a bag. The app's functionality and structure are publicly accessible, so there's a guarantee of no illicit activity happening behind the scenes. Recently, Signal has upgraded its code as well, planning to implement a secure payment feature. The same can't be said about Google Messenger, even though it comes along with the open source Android. Yeah, even the operating system is more transparent than its basic messaging app. But the real reason why I consider Signal the best messaging app on Android is the end-to-end encryption and metadata protection. Signal has one of the best encryption protocols out there, and probably the best of all messaging apps. But before I go in depth into security features, there is one clarification I really need to make. Signal does not support SMS messages anymore, making it a bit different from Google Messages and practically forcing you to use mobile internet or Wi-Fi for communication. App developers cite the security downsides of the SMS format as the reason why these messages are no longer supported. Well, this makes sense, but that's more important. SMS is kind of dying now. The new RCS, or Rich Communication Service format, is bound to replace SMS soon. Even Apple is planning to transition to it once iOS 18 rolls out. Took those guys long enough, even with the EU's constant nagging. Despite being a mostly Apple issue, this is important, as previously, if you were sending Apple users RCS protected messages, they did not get encrypted, as iOS did not support RCS. Now, as promised, let's take a look at Signal's safety and privacy features. My favorite thing about this Android messaging app is that I can chat without revealing my phone number. Usernames replace those. And when I receive notifications, I don't have to worry that someone will accidentally see the message. Notifications are fully customizable. If the messages themselves are sensitive, they can be sent for a limited period of time, disappearing as soon as the timer ends. Messages aside, Signal even allows me to relay all my calls through the app and the encryption. A huge privacy boost for simple conversations. My only issue is that this has to be enabled manually, so make sure to enable always relay calls in the privacy settings when you get the app. Besides all that, Signal supports voice chats and calls through the app, text messages with GIFs and media, and if you have tons of friends or colleagues to coordinate, each group chat can have up to 1,000 people. Not that you'll need that much. So, what are the cons of this completely free and open source messenger? Well, it's not very widespread. Chances are some people you are often communicating with have never heard of Signal, in which case, well, recommend this video to them. But still, the lack of SMS support, internet requirement, and security some find excessive are surely a turnoff for somebody seeking a straightforward messaging app for Android. So if your friend group doesn't want to switch to Signal, or your parents get confused with its settings, WhatsApp is the best Android messaging app for you. Yeah, everyone knows WhatsApp, what a shocker. An app with 3 billion users and over 5 billion downloads. Why is it even here, I bet you're asking? Well, that's because after Signal, it's objectively just the second best option to replace Google Messages. Reason one, end-to-end encryption. It literally has the same one as Signal, and it's the most secure communication protocol available on the market today. A reason two, popularity. Chances are, all the people you communicate with already use WhatsApp. It's ridiculously popular after all. Reason three, accessibility. It's a free app that's very easy to use and manage. Even beginners will find the app comfortable to explore. A reason four, versatility. WhatsApp supports all media formats, allows group chats with over 1,000 people, and even offers dedicated business tools and broadcast channels. Naturally, WhatsApp is not a miracle app. I still have a few gripes with it, which can make WhatsApp seem like a less appealing option for you. For instance, while WhatsApp supports disappearing messages, they can only be used in one-on-one chats. Unlike Signal, WhatsApp can't relay calls and doesn't offer metadata protection. There's no SMS support either, but most importantly, WhatsApp is owned and managed by Meta, the same company that's behind Facebook. And well, you know how those guys treat their security. Spoiler, Not very well. Still, I believe WhatsApp benefits outweigh the negatives unless you are very, very conscious about your privacy, in which case, Signal is the better choice. In conclusion, Google Messages is not an irreplaceable Android message app. You might need to step away from the SMS format to maintain the best security and privacy for your communications, but with apps like Signal or WhatsApp, it's really easy to do. The only difference is that Signal will fit the best for the privacy-conscious users who need advanced cross-platform communication, while WhatsApp is a better option for casual users who simply want to maintain their connection and don't feel bothered by the meta ownership. Now, make sure to leave a like and subscribe to the channel, and don't hesitate to let me know which topic I should cover next in the comments section down below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon.